Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Cheryl Sherman, please. She traveled all the way out here because, you know, it's nationally known what we're starting to do here. Look at all you beautiful people. I'm starting to see a little bit of haze. The weatherman said something about gonna be hazy. I don't know. I was saying I'm glad that we're gonna get to see smoke in front of this part of Boston. We always get clouds in front of this part right here. I want these to disappear. So the next figures that are coming to the stage, I bet you everybody who's here has seen one or two of them before. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Mike Cann and the King of Pop.
Is it live?
Wow.
We're live. I can't talk up a thing, I'm sorry. How's everybody doing out there? How do you love this freedom we're having right now today? You're all out there, you're smoking this wonderful herb, and you're not going to jail like years before. Why? Because we changed the laws here. That's why. It was you guys that helped change the law. So you can all give yourselves a hand of applause to help to change these laws, but we're not through yet. And my brother in the movement right here, he's got me political. I used to do a lot of entertainment in, but I'm coming out political now. I'm going to turn it over to Mike. He's going to tell you what's going on here.
And we've talked to a lot of politicians, and we've won two huge election wins in this state. No one thought we could do it. Listen, we can do this. 2016, we're running a campaign here. We need you to get registered. We need you to talk to the city council. They fucked with us again this year. It don't need to happen. You need to get involved.
We need you. You guys are the ones that got to go out there and vote.
And these politicians will listen to you.
They're listening to us now.
We go in there, they don't know what to think of us. At the end of the meeting, they agree with us. We need more of you guys to do the same thing. Call your city councilor. Call your state rep. It takes 5 minutes. If everybody here did it, we'd have it legal, not 2016, tomorrow.
How many of you want it legalized tomorrow? Being able to walk down the street and smoke it just like a regular cigarette would. That's the way it should be.
And we got a lot of support here. If you look around today, we got Russ Belleville over here. Let's hear him for Russ Belleville.
Russ Belleville!
This guy's been doing radio. He's been doing the movement for a long time. We also got, I just saw her, Joni Emery.
You know Joni!
Mark Emery's wife. He's here today. I want her up on stage
where
right
is
now.
Where's Joni?
We need Joni Emery.
Where's Joni Emery?
We also got Diane Russell.
Everybody look at this man. Okay.
Let's hear it for her.
Look at the shirt that I'm wearing. This is a man's wife. You don't know their story. You need to find out. Jody, you around?
And we're running a campaign. We're going to legalize it in 2016. We need your help. Join MassCan. Check out our websites. We're running. Right here. We don't want to grow weed for you. We want you to be able to grow weed for yourselves. Can I say that again? Say that again, Kim.
Grow weed for yourselves. That's right, because we're going to change these laws, and we're going to make sure that these laws are good for all of us. And I just want to say, right next to me, I got the proud honor to have Joni Emery, and I'm shaking because I idolize the man that she's married to, and I've been following this man, Mark Emery, for many, many, many years. And the reason why I came out the way I did as the King of Pot was because I watched what he did in Canada. He was a Canadian activist and had balls. He stood up for the cause. He did it for all of us. And our own DEA went into Canada and put him away. It's not right. And that has to change. And this woman's been going around for a number of years getting that information out to everyone.
Let's hear it for Joni.
Let's hear it for Joni Emery. Welcome to the stage.
Let's hear it for Mark Emery.
I guess I'm a bit early on stage. Maybe I'll speak again later. I don't know how much time I have. But holy smokes, you guys, you have no idea how awesome this is. Back in 1994, my husband, Mark Emery, the Prince of Pot, began selling marijuana seeds to you, the American people, and people all over the world. He said, when you buy my marijuana seeds, I will give millions of dollars D.C. is legal because of Mark. Mark did so much for the American people. He said, plant the seeds of freedom and overgrow the government. Overgrow the government.
Don't let the government control
Mark Emery said, overgrow the government, and for that, the United States government went to my country of Canada, stole him, and brought him down here facing life in U.S. prison for his activism and for funding the American and global marijuana movement. They admitted that was the reason. He took a 5-year plea deal so he wouldn't die in prison. I just saw him last weekend down in Mississippi. And let me tell you, when you go somewhere like Mississippi and you come someplace like this or Seattle Hemp Fest, you're blown away by the difference, and you realize that even though you are here today free to celebrate freedom and fight for more freedom, many others are not free. And while you have access today, people are suffering and dying in different states. Your own neighbors, your brothers and sisters, they need your help too.
Yes, they do. And that's
so
why we're here. That's why we're here.
Keep fighting. Get involved. Keep pushing. You guys have medical marijuana and decrim? Canada doesn't have any of it. You guys, keep it up. Keep it up, because you're leading the example for the world. For the world. You are leading the example for the world. Keep it up. Please keep it up. I'm going to wrap up to let the music get on stage. But I think I'm back here speaking again later, I hope. I'll get a few more words in. My name is Jody Emery, Cannabis Culture Magazine, Pot TV, and my husband, my hero, Mark Emery, the Prince of Pot, in prison, home next year, let's hope. But keep the fight going, and let's celebrate freedom at the Boston Freedom Rally.
Thank you, Boston! Sad stories and heartbreak, a lot of comeuppance. But a spoonful of sugar makes the medicine go down. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for research and development!